Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello friends, welcome to Entry. I'm Mirza Ehtisham Beg, your quant educator, and today I am going to discuss the strategy for mains examination. As you can clearly see the title, which is written as IBPS RRBPO Mains Quantitative Aptitude Strategy. What you are going to do in the mains exam and how will be the examination and what kind of a level this examination will produce. Okay, so all the things related to this video will be discussed in this video. All right, so first of all, you should know that as we know that the prelims examination has almost over for RRB. In fact, the PO examination was over way before the clerk one. Okay, so what I'm going to say is that you have to start preparing for the mains examination. For only those candidates will start preparing for mains who believe that they can clear the cutoff. And I believe all of you knows about yourself that whether you will clear the exam or not. Okay, so let's move on and let's see what the quant strategy would be. First of all, you should know the mains pattern. Okay, look at the mains pattern. In reasoning, you will be given 40 questions for 50 marks. For GA, I believe the GA segment will be a game changer for those aspirants who wants to clear this examination, because it is the only difference between prelims and mains examination. Computer knowledge, everyone knows about it, but you should know that don't attempt too many questions of computer knowledge, because you will be getting easy paper, no doubt about that. But if you try to fluke the question, you might end up getting negative mark. Okay, because if you are doing two questions correct, then you will be getting only one number. Okay, so the ratio for marks and questions would be 1:2. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is that accuracy has to be your top priority. Look, these are the examination pattern, and we have to discuss only third serial number subject, where you will be getting 40 questions for 50 marks. Okay, there is no time restriction for a specific subject. That means you will be given a total time and you have to solve the paper within that time. What will you get in the RRB mains quant paper? Here, you will be getting 40 questions where you will be dealing with some DIs, arithmetic problem, and a new pattern inequality. What I'm going to say is that this new pattern inequality wouldn't be like the prelims one. Okay, as we have seen in the prelims examination that you have been given lots of quantity 1 and quantity 2 kind of questions. But in the mains exam, you might find some of the fill in the blanks questions. Okay, fill in the blanks question. What is the fill in the blanks question? Because you should be aware of that. Let's say that it is like a closed test of English. Okay, you will be given a paragraph and some of the data will be missing. Okay, so it will be a combined portion of Caslet and missing. Okay, so Caslet and missing will be a combined portion for a new kind of DI. You will be given 2 to 3 questions over that particular paragraph. Okay, what I'm trying to say is that you have to focus on these three topics. In the previous year examination, we have seen 4 DI was being given to you, in which 2 were Caslet and rest of them will be like line or circle or pie chart. Okay, so these are the things you have to deal with that. Okay, what I'm trying to say is that you will be given arithmetic portion as well. So this combined new pattern inequality, or you can say Q1, Q2 and arithmetic section will be combined of based on arithmetic topics. Okay, arithmetic topics. So you have to be very specific about choosing a question, because you wouldn't have much time and you have to deal with this section. Okay, you can spend majority of the time over here. Why? Because it is the only scoring topic, okay, where you can score freely. All right, first when you sit in the examination, when you sit down in the examination and you start the examination, you will first attempt the GA portion and then go to computer knowledge. Okay, I believe you will do 40 plus question within 20 minutes. Okay, if you do that, you will be able to on top of the examination. Okay, what I'm trying to say is that preserve your time. Okay, preserve your time by doing smart choices. Okay, and don't get stuck in any of the lengthy question. If you think these 3 or 4 line question will be lengthy, just skip that question. And one more thing, try to attempt arithmetic portion first. Okay, if you attempting arithmetic portion first, you will be seeing that you can solve 5 questions easily, because the PO mains paper level is not as high as the IBPS PO or SBI PO paper. Okay, remember that it's not like IBPS PO or SBI PO. So what I'm trying to say is that you can solve questions easily. It's just a matter of which question you are going to choose first. Which question you are going to choose first. So remember everything. All right. So which question you are going to choose first is, it depends on your practice. Now let's come on to the practice part. Okay, practice pattern, but you have to decide the practice pattern as well. As we are talking about quant section, that means you have to focus on lengthy and calculative DI. Why? Because if you start focusing on lengthy and calculative DI, you will end up in a good practice. Okay, why? Because you'll keep doing all the hard work, and when the examination day arrived, you will be ready for any of the examination, whether we are talking about IBPS PO or SBI PO. So start preparing for yourself like you are preparing for IBPS PO or SBI PO. Focus on lengthy arithmetic problem, but you should know that start with easier. Once you got the rhythm, move to the arithmetic section. Okay, what I'm trying to say is that if you do hard work here, you will end up getting succeeded. Okay, so it is my strategy for quant section, and you have to deal with that. Remember that you have to be spot on, because you will be getting lots of lengthy questions, okay, and calculative ones. So if you are prepared for lengthy and calculative ones, you will definitely succeed. Okay, so one thing you should know that probability, some of the topics I'll, all right, as you know that you will be focusing on lengthy and calculative ones, so let me give you some of the topics where you can see all the lengthy and calculative ones. You can get lengthy question from time and distance. You can get lengthy questions from profit and loss. Okay, you can get from partnership, all right, and from probability as well. So you have to focus on these topics. I'm sure you will be getting some of the questions from here in lengthy form, so don't think that you will be at ease during the whole examination. Okay, so that's it from my analysis. I hope you have enjoyed this analysis, and if you like it, share, comment and subscribe our YouTube channel. Till then, stay with Entry, stay safe, and good luck for your examination.